In this tutorial, we will be transforming some zoning data from the City of Vancouver from Map Info tab to Esri Shape. Drag the Map Info zones.tab file into the data inspector and click OK. We have area features representing the zones. We also have two attributes in our zones data, zone name and zone category. Notice as I scroll that there are multiple categories that end with the word dwelling, such as two-family dwelling, one-family dwelling, multiple-family dwelling, and so on. Our goal is to combine all zones that end with the word dwelling and create an Esri shape file of zones that only represent family dwellings. Let's open FME Workbench and create a new workspace by selecting the Generate Workspace option in the Getting Started window. Select Map Info tab for the source format, and for the dataset, navigate and select the zones.tab file. For the writer format, select Esri Shape. And for the dataset, select a folder in which to create the new shapefile. We'll select the output folder to create the workspace. There are two things to notice here. First, FME has automatically put in a geometry filter transformer. This is because we are translating data from a format that can handle multiple geometries per file to a format that only allows one geometry per file. Remember, we are dealing with area or polygon features in our source dataset. So let's delete the geometries we don't need. We'll right-click and delete the underscore point, underscore line, underscore text, and underscore geom tables on the output side. We also know that we don't have ellipses in the data, so we'll select this connection and delete it. Let's expand the attributes on our destination feature type. Notice also that FME has automatically trimmed the zone category field to 10 characters due to this shapefile attribute length limitation. Let's go into the properties of our destination feature type and change the name of its attribute. Click on the cogwheel icon to bring up the feature type properties. In the User Attributes tab, click on the field to rename and type in the new name. We'll change it to Category. Let's go back into the General tab and rename our output feature type to Dwellings. This will better reflect what data is to be written. Click OK. Notice that the import for the category has turned red, which means that it's no longer connected to the source zone category attribute. We'll fix this soon. We'll use a tester to filter out the zone categories that end with the word dwelling. Click on the connection between the geometry filter and the destination feature type. Type tester and select it to add it to the canvas. Open up its properties by clicking on the cogwheel icon. Let's create a test clause that filters out zone categories that end with the word dwelling. For left value, drop down the attribute list and select attribute value zone category. Double-click in the operator field to see the drop-down list. From here, select ends with. For the right value, type in dwelling, then click OK. Features that pass this test clause are mapped to the destination. We still need to take care of our category red port. Place an attribute renamer on the canvas. Open its parameters and map zone category to category. Go ahead and run the workspace. Notice that out of 416 features, 90 have met the test clause. A quick inspection of the output shows us which features are in our new Dwellings shapefile.